Patrick Cook here, fractal artist, starving fractal artist. Anyway, so welcome to the next session in our project-oriented tutorial of the Mandelbulb 3D software. Like I've talked about in the previous sessions, this is a project that I have in mind utilizing the Mandelbulb 3D software that will give me a very interesting simulated virtual environment by which I can animate a fly-through. And I'm going for high resolution, I'm going for detailed animation, and all of that, of course, takes time, it takes effort, and it takes work. But in the end, I think that a project of this scope will be interesting. But more importantly, is a project of this scope will give us a platform by which we can discuss the Mandelbulb 3D software. And this is where we left off in the last session, where the Mandelbulb software, using the three primary tools, the main, the navigator, and the animation, combined with these by manipulating the various properties and camera positions and keyframes and that sort of thing, we can get to a point where we have the resources to be able to generate a very interesting Mandelbulb 3D animation. All right. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to get our graphic. Now, I'm going to just pull this up on the full screen again here. This is the concept graphic. This is made with the Mandelbulb 3D software. It's a still, and it's high resolution. It's what 2560 by 1600 pixels, and this is the concept. This is how I want my animation to look in terms of the graphic. Now, obviously, there's no movement in here, but I can envision that I can fly through. I can animate the camera to simulate a fly through of an environment like this. I kind of think of this as urban decay, because you've got a lot of very interesting geometric objects down here. You got a lot of curves. You've got a lot of very interesting curves. You've got depth. You see the depth in there? All right. You've got some lines. There's a lot of photographic principles that one can spot in this kind of a graphic. You also have the diagonal. All right, which in a diagonal line in photography is kind of generates a tension. You're not really the viewer is not really quite sure where they're going. All right, they're banking. There's tension. Matter of fact, the old directors like Alfred Hitchcock kind of invented this whole idea of tilting the camera, which then gave the scene a tilt. And the idea was to create tension, imbalance. So a lot of what you can get from these Mandelbulb 3D fractals, you can replicate much of that. The principles that we strive for in photography. I'm an advanced amateur photographer as well. really interested in infrared photography. But that's a different world. So this graphic right here is interesting because it's got a variety of shapes. It has curves, it has diagonals, it has a kind of enclosure, which is another sense of tension. And I think that this would make a very interesting fly through. Anyway, let's get back to the software. This is what we need to make. All right. So here's our software. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to reinvent that graphic. I have it somewhere, but I don't know where it went. So I'm just going to reinvent it. And besides that, we can all kind of watch and see how it develops on our own. I don't need the navigator right now. I'm just going to close that down. I'm going to close that down. All right. So I need to recreate that graphic or something close, well, or something like it. All right. So I'm going to start with the formulas tab. Now, with the Mandelbulb software, we have six different formula slots. I'll call them slots. Formula 1, Formula 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, that means that we can actually assign six different formulas that would go into making up this particular Mandelbulb graphic. Currently, we only have formula number 1, which is indicated by that little dot or asterisk right to the right of the formula name. If I had a formula here, I'd have another asterisk there, that sort of thing. So this indicates to me that I have one fractal formula defined at this time, which when I calculate, all right, is giving me this particular graphical structure. All right, so I have six of these formulas that I can work with, six formula slots. Now, up here, they're even describing that a little bit for you here. The alternate, I would be able to, if I was on the alternate, which is the default, formula. Formula handling, all right. The software will alternate between formula 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6, or whatever I have defined. Obviously, it's not going to alternate a formula that is not defined at all. I can interpolate, where the interpolation will happen between formula 1 and 2. You notice I don't have formulas 3 through 6 anymore. All right, so this is just interpolating between two formulas. That's it. And I have the DE combinate. Now, DE stands for distance estimate. It's a method, it's an old school method of ray tracing. We'll get into that at some point down the line. But here, with the DE combinate, it says here, DE combinate formula 1 is DE combined with alternate hybrid of formula 2 and 6. Basically, it will combine the distance estimation of formula 1 against formulas 2 through 6. All right? I mean, you're talking advanced stuff there, but that's okay. That's okay. That's what it's for. In my particular case, in order to reproduce this particular fractal, I really only need the alternate. So that's what we're going to do. So let's stop here. In the next session, what I'm going to do is we're going to start defining the formulas here, so that I can move toward getting my base fractal image that we're going to use ultimately for our animation. All right, so let's stop here. I'll see you in the next session, and we'll continue our discussion of the Mandelbulb 3D software in terms of our animation project that we're currently working on and discussing. I'll see you there.